to have met as ranked opponents, and they're underway. Charlie Jones over the 25 and knocked down as he gets about to the 28-yard line. They need three. Petras hits wide. He's looking for the tight end, Sam Laporta, and it'll be three and punt on the opening possession for Iowa.
And when you're
in his career, taking three of them back to the house. On third down, Purdy lofts it over the top. Can't make the connection. He was out there looking for the freshman, Jalen Noel, and each team has it. Each team punts after three plays. See if Iowa is able to take advantage of what figures to be pretty good field position. Charlie Jones has a crease. He's into Cyclone territory, and he is sent rear end over tea kettle after that low kind of a hang time of just over 3 seconds, and Jones made him pay for it. He was in trouble. McDonald's got him, and down it goes. A save it with a 50-yard field goal attempt. And there was a little bit of trouble with the snap and the hold, and it is no good, and the Cyclone defense stands tall.
Purdy's able to completion to Rush, got the 9 yards on first down, and now they pick up a first down on the ground going back to Breece Hall.
And second down and 8, direct snap. This is to Jairo Brock. Brock's got a first down, and they're moving into Hawkeye territory.
Here's Purdy.
Purdy complete to Xavier Hutchinson, and Hutchinson slips down the left sideline. The whip on the tackle from Riley Moss. That's a rarity.
And it's a good pickup of 8 on first down.
Now they'll go back to Hall, and he's got another first down, and the Cyclones do have a rhythm going against this tough Iowa D.
Time, mind of the Cyclone fan, to slant Hutchinson, and nothing doing. It's going to be fourth down. Excellent coverage here by Iowa.
3 to give the Cones the lead. And he does, and Iowa State is on the board first.
After the emotional Florida State finish, Toledo's a good team, a veteran team.
Purdy's going up top. Going to take a big one, and it's going to be picked off by Matt Hankins, who played the ball in the air beautifully.
Boy, Hankins does a great job. A veteran, one of the leaders of this defense, 30th start tonight. This ball, to me, is thrown late. Hutchinson can go. He's got great speed, gets away with a little pull on the jersey, but you can see how late the football is. It's not underthrown. He just got it out. He had too many hitches, and he let the ball go late, allowed Hankins, who was in great position, to go off.
Now it opens up variety of options. Iowa instead will keep it on the ground with Whitson and pick up first down. Yeah.
Pete Rizzo fires a dart into Luke Lachey, one of the tight ends. They use the tight end so well here.
Yeah.
Line of scrimmage. Potabomb's out there. Goodson has it on the corner, and he's inside the 10, and he's got the first down. Aishim Young stopped him, but it'll be first and goal for the Hawkeyes. You know, more customary role for Potabomb now. Lead blocker. And there goes Tyler Goodson, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown. After the Hankins pick, Petras leads the scoring drive.
Watch Linderbaum turn his body. Watch the center, 65. Work to the right and then turn his body. The entire offensive line just trying to create just a little bit of a seam. Here's the progressive pylon cam. Goodson gets across that goal line before his knee touches.
A lot of that in the first half. Third down now for Petras. He took it right in the mouth when he threw it, and then Laporta caught it. How about Petras getting hit in the mustache by Hummel and still delivering the strike?
High school records. And third and very short. Hawkeyes push it straight ahead. Ball moving, they did. They called it down, and Iowa has it back, and now there's another completion for Petras, this time to Charlie Jones.
Got a second down and 10. Let's get it off of the play clock. Petras lofting it toward the end zone, and it's Charlie Jones, and he's got it for a touchdown. Mm-hmm.
Well, if you're an Iowa fan, you've been kind of wondering who's going to emerge as our go-to wide receiver. And right before our eyes, we're starting to see the leading candidate, 16, Charlie Jones. Safety goes with the tight end, Lachey, opens up a very tight throw there. Got to go over top with a safety.
The ball on them, even in these kind of situations.
Purdy getting heat. Escape. Ball has it. First down and more. Gets up close to the 45. Clock will stop to move the chain.
And what is
the yard line ring? It was Purdy. Got a lot of protection. Is what they do. Hall pushing. Did he get any dead? Touchdown, Iowa State.
Again, with the timeout, that's what gives you that chance to be able to make that. And what a call, and what a block by Russ. Yeah, he got it.
Yeah, he got in there.
He got it.
How they'd share that with their players is really moving. Ball is on the ground. A fumble, a scoop, and a score. It's another turnover, and Jack Campbell is in the end zone. An absolutely awful turn of events for the Cyclones. But there is a flag.
There is no foul on the previous play. The result of the play is a touchdown.
Justin Jenkins does a really good job here getting off of the block by Chase Allen, 11. He's right here. Watch him take on Allen, who's a big man at tight end. Takes him on, extends his arms, and then gets his hand right on the football against Breece Hall. Knocks it loose, and there's his cohort, Jack Campbell, to pick it up and walk into the end zone.
Second turnover for Iowa State. The last one led to a touchdown,
which was critical.
And Klein was the Big Ten punter of the year last year with Purdy. See if he has it. Right through the hands of the receiver, and Seth Benson has another turnover. Third of the day for the Cyclones.
You just said it. They're going to make you beat them. They're going to force you into mistakes. Can you be patient? Can you be methodical and work your way down the field? This time, it just goes right through the hands of Hutchison. They're sitting back, keeping the ball in front of them. And how about the reaction time by Seth Benson?
Petrus, feeling the heat. And down he goes. Who has a regain with a huge sack. Trying to reach for a long one from 51 yards out. It is on the way, and it is good. Excellent technique. And it's bad if you're Iowa State, no matter how you slice it. Next snap to Breece Hall. Hall trying to make up for that earlier fumble, and he is running with abandon up across the 40-yard line. Despite losing a couple of starters from a year ago, he's been very active and very good, but they can't stop Hall from getting the first down. Inside a minute to play in the third quarter. Purdy fires to the outside, and it's intercepted by Matt Hankins. Hankins slips a tackle, and another, still on his feet. Hankins down to the 20-yard line, and it is another Iowa State miscue.
Before everybody looks at Brock Purdy, you got to look at Joe Evans, the defensive end from Iowa, who I think got a hand on that football right at the line of scrimmage. Watch 13 right here. This isn't just Purdy with a poor throw. I think he gets up. He did. He got a hand on the ball. Ball ended up going in a different direction. And give Hankins a lot of credit for being able to have his eyes on the ball, sitting.
The sun setting on their hopes of ending their losing streak against Iowa. But here goes Tyler Goodson. First down inside the 10. First down and goal for the Hawks. Petrus lobbing out of the reach of Sam Laporta. To end the drive with a kick attempt. 22 yards, and Iowa tacks on three more, and now the lead is 17. And this
happens to be 6'6", so that's a perfect prospect for them as a tight end. Great athlete.
Matt Campbell getting some younger players some action. Hunter Deckers in there, and
And it was his fellow corner Riley Moss. Today has been Hankins. Really, the whole Iowa defense has just been outstanding. Tariq Milton making up it.
Is that they've been able to come up with to turn into 20 points.
It's Hunter Deckers who replaced Brock Purdy. And he gets it out of the backfield and gets it to Eli Sanders. This is a program with stability under Matt Campbell. Deckers throws for the end zone, and it's grabbed by Milton. With 3.5 to go, and the Cyclones put another touchdown up.
How about Deckers? Plenty of time, but works himself all the way from the right. Looks like he was trying to find his big tight end, Fuller, and he's covered. Everything's covered to the right. He comes all the way back. This is his fourth option. He finally finds Milton for that touch. Giving other guys an opportunity and finding out a lot of these guys.
Oh, here we go. They've got a real chance. That might be a microcosm of how frustrating this day has been for Iowa State.
Difference in the game is the special teams and turnovers.
Ivory Kelly Martin carries it and is stopped for maybe a loss of one. Steve, he's got a little magic in the last 100 seconds. There's another completion. A good open field tackle by Seth Benson. Ohio State still the gold standard despite stumbling against Oregon today. Deckers gets rid of it, and Iowa State will have a few more plays, picking up first down if, depending on what we have on the flag back at the 30-yard line.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Defense, number 97.
A lot of the earlier downs.
Deckers flipping it underneath. It's Sanders again. Sanders turns a corner. He's headed toward the first down marker and the out-of-bounds marker.
Down and at least give yourself a chance here. But you got to hit the kick.
It's been that kind of day. Last-ditch effort goes awry.